This is a very quick tip about where colors are coming from in Illustrator. So this is the start screen of Illustrator. There's no document open, and I'm going to switch into the application itself. Now here's the application, no document, and we're going to take a look at the Swatches panel. And you see it's empty. There are no swatches, and also I cannot set up any. This is different in other applications, for example, InDesign. But in Illustrator, the swatches are not part of application-based settings. So where do they come from? When I'm creating a new document, let's take this one and then go to the swatches again. Then you see there are swatches. The new documents are based on some templates that reside in your user folder or in the application folder, and they contain swatches. When you open an Illustrator file, then there might be swatches depending on what the creator of this document made in them. When you open other file types, so let's open this TIFF, then we get no swatches because the TIFF doesn't contain any. It cannot. In this TIFF file, I can work with all Illustrator tools and then save that as a vector file. This is not recommended, actually. So when you want to work based on some raster image, then it's better to create a new document and then place your raster image into it. And the swatches are one reason for that. So now that we've done that, maybe it's the workflow we want to use, then how do we get swatches? One way is to just create some. So I can click on New Swatch and create new swatches. That's one way. The other way is to go in here, into the libraries, select the library and get the swatches from it. So let's go to the nature ones and go to this one. There are swatches. I can select all these groups and then go in here and add them to swatches. And there I have swatches and I can use them from the swatches panel or from here or from the properties or wherever there are swatches inside the menus.